And we're back with more Life is Strange Before the Storm. So, let's get into it.
Alrighty. We are back. We are continuing with Life is Strange Before the Storm. What we're supposed to do with the amulet. Well,
one time we stuck a bunch of this tape to Chloe's face to make a blue beard. Putting it on was a lot more fun than taking it off.
It's painter's tape. It doesn't hurt that much. Although, that being said, I bet you Chloe's dad was fucking pissed. Blue painter's tape is expensive. Good painter's tape is expensive.
All I'm saying is, I've never broken my wrist taking a picture. I'm really gonna miss Price Family Barbecues.
Alrighty.
Hey, Chloe.
Yar.
Land ho.
Perfect.
Alrighty.
Wait just a minute. Yar. You must ask permission before setting foot or peg on another captain's boat.
Permission to come aboard, Captain Bluebeard?
Grrr!
One amulet coming right up. Later. I can barely
talk. Well, that's pretty dorky.
I think it goes. Damn it. I forget how to make this stay on. Stay here. I think I saw some tape. Thanks, Max.
Aces.
Just some tape left between us and the treasure. Chloe's bottle rocket. The fastest way to get an entire bottle of soda in your hair.
Probably.
Yo-ho, yo-ho, a pirate's rum for me. Do you drink this? Yar.
No, not really. I had to fish an empty bottle from the recycling bin.
Probably for the best.
Some pirate you are.
I mean, hey, why not just drink a boatload of rum? Seems like a perfectly acceptable thing for a 13-year-old to do.
I wish I could freeze this moment and never have to leave it.
He could also not be such a...
How jolly can you be if you're dead?
Fair point. You could also stop being such a sentimental bitch.
Glider swings. The best way to simulate a storm on the high seas. This thing looks so much smaller than I remember. I can't believe Chloe still has it. Actually, after this morning, I can.
Bitch hasn't thrown out anything since the fifth grade.
I've spent so much of my life here. Every little corner is familiar. Comforting. These games we're playing. Buried pirate treasure from our past selves.
Well, isn't that the entire...
Why I keep pushing off telling Chloe I'm leaving. Because I don't want to ruin this time together.
Probably.
How am I going...
What's up, dude?
Bro.
Don't you mean sis?
Maybe I meant nerd. Door. Hunk.
Hunks are cool. Good talk.
Well, that'll make a whole lot sense in another couple of episodes.
I wish I could live in the world we drew. Chloe and I have done lots of homework at this table.
Tire garden.
This was a fun experiment. I'm almost surprised we actually managed to grow something.
Well, of course you did. You didn't water it with gasoline like I would have.
It's not that I don't like the blue. I'm just sad to see the old color go.
Tape!
Score! One step closer to getting that treasure. Whatever it is.
Okay, okay. Anything else? I think we've looked at everything. Oh!
I wish this was big enough to jump in.
Yeah.
It's only September. It'll be totally dive bombable in a few weeks.
Yeah. A few weeks.
You're really not all that good at hiding the fact that you're leaving for Seattle tomorrow.
If you told me this morning that we'd be spending the day as pirates, I would have thought you were crazy.
Yeah, I probably look like a loser, huh?
Yeah, totally. But we're losers together. See?
If you're a loser, Max, I don't think I want to be cool. It's just, this whole day has made me feel like a little kid again.
I can't believe we were 8 and 9 when we planned this.
I can. This tiny kid's head is squeezing the shit out of my head.
Well, treasures don't find themselves.
Lead the way.
Alrighty, tape.
Ahoy, Bluebeard! I have brought the stickiest tape in all the Seven Seas.
Well done, fellow scallywag. Just like old times. Huh, Max?
Remember how we used to talk about ruling the bays of Arcadia one day? We thought we were gonna be pirates forever. If being a pirate means acting silly and going on crazy adventures together, then we'll always be pirates. Hell yeah.
Would you like to do the honors, Long Max Silver?
Me? Are you sure?
Of course. Come on, Navigator. Point me to some treasure.
Right-ho!
Wait, how am I supposed to use this?
The drawing on the lens. It should line up with something?
Here goes nothing. Okay, this drawing is supposed to line up with something.
Now, okay. Aha!
Got it.
Yes! You rock! Where is it? Here?
That'd be your left.
Okay, take a step left. No, wrong way.
You said left.
I meant your left. Yeah, your other left.
Your other left. Go the other way.
The other way to my other left?
Yes.
Just go that way. Perfect. Now come towards me. Bingo.
You really should call 311 or, you know, click before you dig. Things like that. You don't want to hit a gas line. Or, you know, some high voltage electrical. That'd cut this pirate adventure real short.
What the? That
Well, I guess we'll find out what the hell it is. Come on, baby, hurry up and load. Do do do.
What is this?
I don't know. Let's open it.
From Bloody Bill. Who's that?
I'll get the tape player.
Aha. Chloe's dad is such a goofball.
There's a chair for a reason.
Ahoy there, plankwalkers. It's me, Bloody Bill, the Pirate King.
What?
By now, you'll have seen that I dug up your treasure, which would normally make us mortal enemies. But hear me out. I haven't pilfered a thing. On the contrary, I figured you swashbucklers might not be back to your loot for some time, so I've given it extra protection from the winds and rain. I'm sure you're excited to open your time capsule, so I won't go on too long. Just know that Bloody Bill is bloody proud of you. Both of you. Keep those sails trimmed and that anchor scrubbed. And always remember, the real treasure is...
friendship. Love.
Your Oregon State prepaid college savings plan.
That's a good one.
Buried.
Huh, yeah. I guess it probably would have gotten ruined underground. Holy crap! It's Billy the Squid! He's alive! Oh, man!
It really is like a time capsule.
No way!
Chloe, look at this. We wrote each other letters.
Oh, I remember these. Chloe Price. Thanks, Max. I hope you are having a lot of fun being a teenager with your best friend. Aw, you're so cute. Check it out.
Ugh, Maxine.
Summer vacation, da da da. Favorite animal, Arabian horse. Otter. Lobster roll, coffee, ice cream, art of library, science, age, pretty fairy, da da da. Okay. Neat.
How about mine? What did I write?
This is so Chloe.
Alright. Here's a record of how we spend our days. Go to the same school and always sit together. Sleepovers at least once a week. Extremely salty pretzels. We're in a race to see. Convince your parents to get a pet first. We are going to live together when we can afford it. And use only gold paint. We have battled many foes. Da, 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 da. Okay.
You were really sweet.
Oh, man. That was really goopy.
I like it.
That's because you're a goop. This is so cool. There's so much to look at.
Is your mom going to mind about this mess?
Just dunno. I thought they'd be home by now. Max, remember scratch art? Oh, I love this stuff. I'm gonna draw something.
Do-do-do.
These memories. I want this container looks like it could last 100 years.
Holy crap.
It's the end of that comic in Chloe's room. Oh, this is gross.
Okay. These what is awesome. This?
Chloe's...
Flaming Fingers. Oh, good lord. Predictions.
Most of these are pretty far off base. It's so hard to predict the future.
Medium popular. Enjoy the present. Alright. Letters. Tape.
It's good to see you, old friend.
Okay. Well.
Recording things was so much fun in third grade.
Yeah. Alright. What the hell is this shit?
So much more of a mess here than at my house. Manga might be the one thing where Chloe out-nerds me. I love how Polaroid cameras make every photo look a little nostalgic.
Alrighty. Why not? Let's tidy some shit up. You know, be helpful at a friend's house and all that jazz.
Much better.
Just because I'm a goody two-shoes doesn't mean that it's the wrong thing to do.
Short next to Chloe.
What is this?
That was a good week. I used every possible excuse to be here for breakfast.
Week of two ale waffles in your own house. Oh, Lord. Oh, that's right. Is that message still there?
That's the voicemail Chloe's mom was talking about. She did say she didn't want Chloe to hear it. But if Chloe's in trouble at Blackwell, this might be my only chance to get her to talk about it.
Fuck it, we're gonna do it.
This is Anne Rogers, Marissa's mother. Marissa from Blackwell. I need to talk to you about what your daughter did to Marissa in class today. I'll be keeping Marissa home with me tomorrow. At this point, I'm not comfortable sending her back to school at all. I don't know if your daughter is having trouble adjusting or what, but this needs to be addressed.
Hey, hold on.
Are you serious? I don't want my parents to hear that. I've never gotten in trouble like this before.
They already know. I saw an email on your parents' computer.
Shit!
What happened?
Something so minor. Her mom is exaggerating. I bet Marissa told her that I'm telling you, it's stupid.
Okay, sorry about that. We're back. I got interrupted for a couple of things there. I had to go and deal with them. Let's get back into it and finish this episode up. Yeah.
Come on. You've got to tell me what happened. I'm your best friend.
Man, none of this would have happened if I had you around. I wouldn't care what anyone said.
Sorry. I don't mean it's your fault.
Anyway, she wouldn't leave me alone, so I turned up her Bunsen burner in science. Just a little.
What?
No one got hurt. Not even close. You know that I know what I'm doing.
Chloe, what do you mean she wouldn't leave you alone?
She was making fun of my clothes and calling me a scholarship kid.
Man,
is
fuck
that
bitch.
Why you wanted to throw away your hoodie?
Don't worry. I'll keep it.
That really sucks. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Thanks, Max.
Well, that bitch. Anything else going on over here?
I bet there's some really cute photos in there.
We're gonna find out.
I could recreate this photo with Chloe now.
Well, you bet your ass we're gonna try.
Looks like Chloe's a lot more responsible than I am with my allowance.
Yeah. I'd say so. I don't know any kid that budget shit like that.
Chloe and I have been friends for so long. Maybe I'm worrying too much about this move changing things.
Righto.
Hey, what if my being in Seattle finally convinces Chloe to try an MMO?
Yeah, good luck with that.
Chloe and I spilled that wine months ago, but I still feel bad about it.
What's going on here? Amulet.
You sure were troublesome to find.
Okay, any other interesting stuff
That's
going
so cool
on?
That Chloe's mom is thinking about this.
Baseball cap. There we go.
Yes?
Pose for a photo with that? Okay, tip your head back and put your arms out. And a really big smile.
Like this?
It's perfect. Stop moving. Really cute, Chloe.
You're not so bad yourself.
Okay.
I still haven't told Chloe about my news. I can do that after I finish looking at everything.
Yeah.
Chloe looks so content when she's drawing. Is that what I look like when I'm taking pictures?
Probably not.
Take a break for a second.
This artist waits for no
stop.
That was worth stopping for.
Righto. Got our photo shoot.
Hey, hippie.
How's the masterpiece?
Working on the last bit. How about you? Done with the time capsule?
Yep.
Yeah, I think so.
Well, perfect, because now I'm finished. Check it out.
This is so silly. This jawbreaker is going to last forever.
Just like our friendship.
Oh, Chloe, you were really drawing me that whole time.
Whoa. Machinist alert. Keep it together, Max.
I guess now's my chance to tell Chloe I'm leaving. We might not be alone again once her parents get back.
Hey, ready for something else? I've got a great plan for the afternoon.
Crap. I don't want to ruin the rest of the day.
You're staying for dinner, right?
Would Chloe even want me to tell her?
Yes.
We've already got enough drama from Blackwell.
Who gives a damn?
Max?
You should tell your friends these
it's
things.
Seattle. I'm probably overstressing about the whole thing.
You're moving to another state.
Right. Tell you something.
Okay.
I'm my family's moving to Seattle really soon.
in 3 days, right?
What? You knew that?
Our parents do talk, you know?
But they said I should be the one to tell you.
They still told my parents. I guess Mom and Dad were trying to keep quiet too, but they're bad at hiding anything. Don't look so worried, Max. It's okay. Come on, Dorkmeister. It's not the end of the world.
I should have just told you earlier. I feel so stupid.
Max, I said it was okay.
I thought about telling you this morning, but then I just felt guilty instead.
Well, I'm glad you didn't. Then it would have been hanging over us all day. That's why I didn't bring it up either. Plus, I know you hate this kind of conversation, so I just left it alone, you know? Come on. I want to spend every minute we have together having fun.
We'll keep in touch, okay? And visit, and maybe we'll move back. Who knows?
Chill out. We can go to college together. It's gonna be fine. We're Max and Chloe, remember? We're always together. Even when we're not.
That's true.
Cool. Let's find something fun to do.
Flies on the windowsill. We are that we are that we are to know. Winter stole summer's thrill, and the river's cracked and cold. See, the sky is no man's land, a darkened plumed estate. Hope it needs a humble hand. Not a fox found in your place.
Well, that's gonna suck. Dad's dead and I'm moving to Seattle. That's really gonna suck for you here.
Thank you.
voice, it could be a little bit like I was there. I don't know. Maybe this was a dumb idea. I would give anything to be there with you now. It's so hard trying to say what I'm thinking. If I could just see you. But we'll get good at it. Great at it. We'll write and talk all the time. And then you'll come visit and it'll be like I never left. I mean it. You don't have to worry about anything changing. You're dealing with so much other stuff. You don't deserve any of this. Chloe, listen. Even if we're moving for good, we are always together, okay? Even when we're apart, we're still Max and Chloe. I will always, always love you. Goodbye.
Alrighty, well, that's it for the first chapter, I guess, of Life is Strange Before the Storm, which is actually the fourth chapter in the game, but chronologically takes place at the beginning. That one wound up being a little bit longer than the other two in this one, but that's just because it was already so close to the end. There was no sense in making another real short episode just for the end there. Like, subscribe, all that jazz, and yeah, till next time.